Life path twos tend to be very loyal, and they welcome companionship and the chance to share their lives with someone special. They are more sensitive to others and have the ability to truly listen. Twos are sincere, honest, and open and see the best in people. Because of their sensitivity, gentleness, and loving spirit, they make an excellent friend or lover. Your compassion and caring for other people also may cause you to deny your own needs in favor of the needs of others, which can also lead to feelings of resentment or anger, and if you feel threatened or pushed to the wall, you can become the terrible twos. However, ultimately you do not want conflict. Few things to be wary if your life path number is two, as your sensitivity can also in some ways be your downfall. Many people with a life path of two are oversensitive, shy, and afraid to speak their minds. Because you are afraid of being hurt, you may avoid confrontation and hold back your opinions. This can cause you to have trouble contributing to a group, and may make you feel resentful because you are withholding your ideas and contributions. Learn this, and your life will change forever. I'd like you to imagine a garden. In this garden, the soil is always rich with nutrients and what you plant, it will grow. There is rain and sun so you don't have to worry about anything. You can plant anything. There are no restrictions. You can plant roses or you can plant poison ivy. You can plant tomatoes or you can plant nightshade, a deadly poison. What you put in, as a seed, will eventually grow into something much bigger. This garden is your mind and the seeds you can plant are your thoughts. Your mind is a fertile place where the thoughts you plant will grow and make up for what your life is. Or as the old passage from the Bible goes, from the book of Proverbs, chapter 23, verse 7. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Your thoughts, your convictions, manifest the surrounding reality. Your life, good or bad, is nothing more than a reflection of the thoughts you've planted in your mind and nourished. These thoughts became behaviors. Behaviors became results. You are where you are right now because deep down in your heart, this is where you wanted to be, no matter how sad or unfair this may sound. This principle is one of the oldest spiritual laws in existence. It's also one of the best known. You may know it under a different term. This is, you become what you think about. And you can find this in all of world's religions. Some variation of this exists in Hinduism, in Christianity, and in basically every other major religion. It's found in all belief systems, as the one used by the Chinese. It's as much of a universal law as gravity. Long before books existed, wise people understood that our thoughts manifest our reality. It works on two levels. First, your beliefs are connected to the universe on a quantum level. We manifest what we really believe. Let me make this clear though. You don't manifest what you think you believe. You manifest what's in your heart. If you believe you deserve unhappiness and pain, then no matter what you say, this you'll get. A great deal of people believe they have positive thoughts when their inner voice is always negative and destructive. That voice will always win. Maybe this is why Loa fails for so many people. They're trying to grow trees of prosperity and success while planting seeds of doubt and pain and suffering. It doesn't work this way. You get what's in your heart. The universe will manifest it. But what's in your heart is the truth, and we may not always know of this truth. Life doesn't give you what you intended. Life gives you what you ask. And while many people intend for wealth and joy and health, their thoughts are of poverty and sadness and despair. Since this is what they're planting, this is what the universe is manifesting. Second, your thoughts lead to beliefs. Your beliefs lead to actions. Your actions lead to outcomes. Your outcomes leads to your destiny. The thoughts you plant in your mind will determine how you act, on a level that's so subtle that you can't even perceive it. Who you are is the consequence of the thoughts you've adopted. It's hard to realize this. It's on the same level of breathing. You realize your breath only if you pay attention. You realize your behavior and where it comes from only if you analyze it. But everything you are comes from the thoughts you've once planted in your mind and then let them become a part of you. So when you plant positive thoughts, you get positive results. When you plant love and happiness, your behavior will reflect love and it will create happiness for yourself and for others. When you plant thoughts of prosperity and wealth, your behavior will create wealth and prosperity in the world. Think of this like the captain of an airplane. An airplane is huge, carries hundreds of passengers and weighs tens of tons. Yet, you will find just one or two pilots in the cockpit, controlling this huge machine. So is with your life. Even if your behavior is infinitely complex, there are just a few thoughts that control all of it, and if you replace those thoughts, everything will change for you too. The thoughts you plant in it will both manifest reality as in creating reality itself and shape your behavior to create the results you want. Both are important. This world is a 50-50 place. The universe can manifest the opportunities you require at this moment, but you must act to take advantage. If luck knocks at your door, you still need to open the door. It's like in this old joke. A fisherman is caught up in a storm. His boat is sinking. Desperate, he prays to God. God, please save me, I'll be good, I'll repent, just save me. A few minutes later, a boat shows up. Hi there, do you need any help? The Good Samaritan asks him. No, no, God will save me, the fisherman answers. Perplexed, the savior leaves. 10 minutes later, the same things happen. Another boat shows up. They offer to help him. The fisherman refuses, saying that God will help him. Eventually, the boat sinks, he dies and goes to heaven. There, face to face with God, he asks. God, why did you left me to die? I prayed to you and I promised I'll repent for my sins. God looks at him and says, what are you talking about? I've sent you two boats. This is a joke, but this is how life works too. We manifest opportunities, but you must take advantage of these opportunities. If you are a real estate agent and you want to close a huge deal, your thoughts will manifest this opportunity. The universe will align the people, places, and circumstances for this to happen. But these people, places, and circumstances won't come to you in your living room. You must still act and do something. Or maybe you want to find the love of your life. Thoughts of love and appreciation will manifest your ideal partner, but your partner won't knock at the door and ask you for a date. The universe is like a tree that offers you the fruits you need, in infinite abundance, but you still must grab those fruits from the tree. And it all starts with your thoughts, with your beliefs. Make a commitment now to fill your mind with positive thoughts. Make a commitment to think only thoughts of love and joy and wealth. At first, it will be hard. If you're used to plant only poison in your mind, it will take a while until you take it all out. But once you do, you'll notice something incredible happening. You'll see how you'll walk into the right circumstances. You'll find yourself in the right places, at the right time, to get what you want. How can I help you do this? Manifestation magic contains hidden NLP commands which act as seeds to plant in your subconscious mind. NLP is a powerful technology built around the best schools of psychotherapy and hypnosis. It allows you to program your subconscious mind, planting seeds into the fertile ground of your mind and heart. This means you can listen to these tracks before going to sleep and change what you think, putting no effort at all. Manifestation magic always contains the best of brainwave entrainment, which trains the brain to operate at a higher frequency and is built around the solfeggio scales, tones that will heal you and help you manifest miracles in your life. Click below to discover how manifestation magic can help you plant better thoughts into your mind and manifest the life you deserve.